Assalamualaikum everyone, this is me, Samima Asad from Crescent School. Welcome to online classes. I am here today with some icebreaker information. So let's see that what is icebreaker. Icebreaker. An effective icebreaker will help you to break the monotony from your daily routine and will warm you up and get yourself ready for your new session. In this video, you will be told about some important discoveries which you never knew. Students, remember one thing, that this the topic or the discussion in this video is not related to your course or book. This is just an additional information for enhance the doctor knowledge, that's it. And it is just an icebreaker information, that's it. Okay, let's start. So today my topic is Dr. Robot. Yes, you have heard right, Dr. Robot. You must have seen doctors working in hospitals and robots working in your cartoons. But today you are going to see how a robot works as a doctor. This is a robot saluting you. Okay, now medical microbot. First we'll see what are robots. A robot is that electromechanical programmed machine who has specific determined functions. But robotics is not only limited to human robots. Instead, there are also very small robots who have artificial parts like metal and have their own identity. Now, let me introduce you to these miniature robots called medical microbots. Medical microbots are those miniaturized, sophisticated programmed robots which are very tiny in size and can be inserted into the living body for performing specific tasks like regulation and screening of body function and delivering drugs to various parts of the body. Medical microbots travel inside your body and give clue of any illness to doctors. You know that our body is a house of various complex pathways and organs, and our body don't run smoothly all the time. Sometimes we feel ill, sometimes we have some infection, some pain or anything like that. So doctors don't have a precise information or clue that what is happening inside our body. But these medical microbots would screen and regulate internal environment with much precision than doctors. Moving on, first medical microbot is pill can. Pill means a capsule, a tablet, and a cam means a camera. So that means camera inside a capsule. Now let's see what is it. Pill cam is a camera that performs the function of human eye. It can visualize objects which human eye can also do. To watch the inner world of living body, this microbot is just like a capsule, having a flashlight and camera in it. You can see in the picture that it is written over there, Pelka, and inside that there is a camera and a flashlight, which the patient will swallow that and it will read inside the body, and there the recording can be seen on the computer screen by the doctor with much precision, and they can and the doctor can see that how it travels with the normal track. It does not have a map, it does not have a navigation system, it just travels normally with the body track. It tells us about healthy and normal state of body. Now number second microbot is drug delivering robot. A microbot made up of magnetic coils instead of motors has been designed by a scientist. The patient is still large enough that is unable to travel through circulatory system. So, to visualize the arteries and veins, this drug delivering robot was designed by Australian team of scientists. These miniature robots succeeded in transferring drugs to the liver of a rabbit, and this robot comprises of different chemicals which release gas and water. The bubbles produced during the reaction have force to go to the smaller arteries. You have studied about heart, arteries and veins. So I'm talking about arteries, that these robots can go inside the arteries. Now, these robots proved to be a golden opportunity for cancer patients to treat their disease instead of painful procedures like radiotherapy, chemotherapy. You must have observed therapies, these kinds of painful procedures in some relatives who is suffering from cancer. Now, this robot helps to transfer medicine to specific areas instead of destroying neighbor areas. Now, this robot is basically replacing that painful procedure, and now we can come up with some robots which can transfer medicines to the body. Moving on, now you can see the robot in the picture. Drug delivering robots. Now, moving on to the third robot, which is bacterial microcarriers. Okay, girls, scientists, after reaching arteries, don't found it sufficient. So they looked up ways of reaching the tiny particles by the help of a robot. Now, bacteria is a small, commonly known as germ, the small organism commonly known as germ, which causes different diseases. However, some bacteria are beneficial to our body as well. Now, after reaching arteries, scientists were looking ways of reaching tiny capillaries by a robot. They found a bacteria which has a magnetic property. You know, a magnet which attracts things? So, a bacteria, a germ, has a magnetic property in it. Scientists found that bacteria and they have spinning tails as well. Now, it has a very tinier diameter than the above robot, and then this bacteria reached the diseased area, it repaired that specific area. Now, I think that is interesting. Let me show you a bacterial microcarrier. This is a bacteria, and it has a magnetic property in it, and when it reaches a specific area, it cures that area. Now, girls, moving on, we have diabetes regulating robots. Now, when robots can cure cancer, then why they can't regulate diabetes? For sure they can. You must have often seen diabetes patients checking their sugar level by glucometer, but as per revolution, scientists found another microbot which is used to regulate diabetes. The diabetic patient has to suffer the problem of checking glucose level several times in a day to maintain it. You must have seen your father or maybe your mother or maybe your grandparents that they are regulating their diabetes. They are checking it by an instrument like this. This is a glucometer. They keep on checking it daily or weekly. But after curing cancer, Australian scientists found a microbot for regulating diabetes. By releasing many microbots inside the body, the doctors will be able to generate many sugar level readings from different locations of body at a time. Now, in this way, diabetes can be regulated in a more smarter way without the inconvenience of self testing. Now, this here in the picture, you can see a microbot, and the doctors will release this microbot inside the body of the sugar patient or diabetic patient, and this microbot will take the sugar level readings of different locations of the body, from the upper body, from the lower body, or wherever, and at one time, simultaneously, it will give you different readings. I hope that you are enjoying, students. Now, moving on, we have the last microbot, which is biopsy performing robot. Now, first, I will tell you that what is biopsy. Biopsy is a diagnostic test for most types of cancer. Like, it is a very painful process. What happens in it is done by removing the lump of cells by biopsy needle. Like, many cells by the help of a needle are removed out of the patient body. It can be in the back, it can be in the front, or in the arm, in the leg, wherever the cancer cells are growing, the biopsy needle is needed to remove the lump of cells to diagnose the type of cancer. But this painful process is luckily replaced by a medical microbot, which is just like a starfish. You can see in the picture, having arms that has ability to grip clump of cells and snatch it from the cancerous area. So these arms have magnetic properties. All right, these arms open before they land. Okay, then the robot it lands on that area, on that area of the body. These arms open and they grip and clump the clump of cells and snatch it from the cancer area. Now this robot works successfully in pig body. They have tested it in the pig body. Now scientists are trying to apply it for biopsy in human brain, blood vessels and other parts. Okay girls, now these all five microbots were new for me when I studied them or when I find them on Google. So I just wanted to share them with you all so that it must have increased your knowledge about more about science. Now what you have to do is you have to go to YouTube and see the videos how these robots are working. Now these all robots are under testing, but they can work. Now you have to go and you will find out more facts about these robots. Now, well, with the grace of scientists, technology is continuously surprising us with modern innovation. The advantageous effects of these innovations motivate us day by day to explore more. Though medical microbots are still not much practical due to less perfection, but surely they will make the treatments much easier and effective in future decades, inshallah. So not only a human can treat disease, but a robot can also help us in this regard. That's why I called it Dr. Robot. I'm pretty sure that I must have changed your typical opinion about robots. Thank you so much and have a blessed day.